when I invest, numbers are not there.
Okay.
Sometimes, you know, even the pitch deck is not there. Even the idea is very, very small.
Right.
What I look in a startup is a founder. Not that they should be IIT or IIM. Clear Dego founders are not neither IIM or IIT. Clenscar founder is not IIT or IIM. I look at them as an individual personality. How they are conceiving the idea and how aggressive they are. And is the focus clear? Are they clear about what they are doing? If that is intact, then the second thing is timing. If the timing is right, in any business, if the timing is right, it's true. If you're selling, you know, umbrellas in a winter season, definitely it won't sell. You have to sell umbrellas in rainy season. That's what the timing is all about. That's what I look at. We all have those misses.
Right.
I do have some great misses.
Right.
Wherein the time sometimes, you know, I fintech is one field where I'm missing every time. So I hope this time I won't miss. Because the time is also there and you know, we have the same 24 hours out of which we need to sleep for 6-7 hours and spend time with our family and then, you know, do our business and then invest. So now I'm a full-time investor. I do miss. The primary reason for missing out on good opportunities is the time itself for me. I don't have the time to talk to the founder sometimes, to go through their deck and then suddenly realize, yeah, why didn't I go through this? That's the only reason I miss. And otherwise, like I said, if the founder is clear and he's presenting his idea in the first line itself, I do respond to them, even by saying no. Most of the VCs don't say no ever. Most of them, but I do say no. And I'm also open for saying them, boss, please stop it, do something else. It's not the business. It's you're trying to sell a Maruti 800 in 2019, whereas you should be looking at selling the battery cars. That's what I tell the founders as well, which is not good, but I do that. What I do is when I invest in a company, I make sure that they have a advisory person or an advisory board ready and onboard a mentor. So there was this small young guy just out of IIT. They created a robot and I realized that they need a mentor. Apart from me, I am being mentoring them because I was appointed as a mentor to them in IIM Lucknow. I found a guy who was better than me in that field, who was from automotive and who was working in the same industry from last 20 years. The mentor got them an 8.4 crore order from Tata's. He knew how to pitch to Tata's. He knew how to write a mail to Tata. And he knew how to get that order. And we got the order to a startup which was really, really great. Even IIM was surprised. A startup which is not even generating much revenue got an order from Tata worth 8.14 crores. That's huge. That's what a mentor do to a startup. And that's what the first thing I do. Secondly, I make sure that during the period of my investment or the money I have given them, they should be able to generate enough revenue that even if they don't raise in future, they still survive. Thirdly, everybody know that 9 out of 10 startups fail. That's true and myth as well. Well, when it comes to me and I have invested in them, they fall in the category of 4 to 5 out of 10. Because 50% of these startups never get funded. So they have to fail. Not saying that they have to fail. They fail because of money they don't have. So idea just remains the idea. Out of the ideas which receive money, I said 4 or 5 out of 10 fail. That means 50%. If they get a mentor, the ratio still goes down. So I make sure that these startups do get a mentor. And I keep on searching for collaborative efforts wherein these startups can get acquired. So 70% of all the companies or the startups get acquired if they are not killed or if they are not dead. If you can get acquired, that's the another way of making money. And that's what you see in the bigger companies like SoftBank. So he's investing in competition as well. He's investing in Ola, he's investing in Uber. So, and Snapdeal, Flipkart. And the time comes when he says, boss, let's merge, like Snapdeal and Flipkart. But then the founders also should have the courage, like Kunal Bahl, who took step and said, no, we are not merging. So 70% of the startups should think at being acquired. only 3% of the startups I look at going to, you know, list or maybe, you know, out of 100, one startup will go for a unicorn status.